Welcome back. Boating season is pretty much here. Long weekend is 4 days away. We're talking boating safety today. We have Corporal Jody Schelke joining us from the Kamloops RCMP. Lots of tips for people to keep in mind and things to think about if you're heading out on the water this weekend.
That's right. And things to keep in mind, especially this time of year, because the water has risen so much in lakes and the rivers, that this time of the year is even more dangerous for boating. And it's something that everybody enjoys doing, but they really have to be cautious and plan ahead.
Mm-hmm. Being on the water and being aware of the deadheads that are out there, I think this is going to only get worse as we see the big rivers crest, so to speak. I know the Shuswap can be chock full of deadheads at the best of times throughout runoff, so that's something to consider. But also, the lakes and the rivers might be very busy with boats. You have to be very cognizant of people around you.
Yes, cognizant of other types of boats like yourself. So if you're in a motorboat, that there's other motorboats out there. Kayaks and canoes that don't respond the same as boats that have engines. Mm-hmm. And also swimmers and sea-doos and everything like that. There's just so many different variables on a river. Mm-hmm. Or on a lake.
Absolutely. We're sort of cycling through some pictures here. You know, boating season here is big. A lot of people wait for these 4 months or 5 months of the year to get their boats out there, but it's just a simple mistake that can ruin your life. We've seen it happen. We've covered stories where that sort of thing can happen. Scenarios like this: you're cruising down the river on your boat, there's kayakers, you've got to be aware of who's around you.
Always be, yes, be aware of who's around you, be aware of what's under the water, and just be aware of all safety things inside of your boat as well. Mm-hmm. So everybody needs a life jacket, should have a life jacket on. Mm-hmm. That you have a plan of where you're going, and you've left this plan with somebody so that if something goes wrong, they know where to look for you. Mm-hmm. And what you were expecting that day, that you have the proper emergency gear in your vehicle, and that if your boat has any size engine, that you've taken the pleasure craft operator's licensing, which is online at BC or at boatinglicense.ca.
Right, and that's important.
Yes.
Don't think you're not going to get checked up on, because Corporal Jody Schelke just telling me now that on the river this year there will be RCMP presence, and they will be pulling people over should they think that there's something going on that they need to check out.
Yes, we have our own boat, and so we'll be out on the river. We do have a breathalyzer with us. And just so people know, that boating and drinking is the same penalties, and it's the same 0.08 that is for driving. So driving a vehicle. So, and also when you're boating and drinking, people become, people don't realize is they can become impaired much quicker. Mm-hmm. Because of the sun and the wind, the stress of operating the boat, things like that. And then even passengers who are drinking. Alcohol causes people's inhibitions to lower and their sense of coordination. Mm-hmm. And people can fall out of boats if they've been drinking, even if they're just a passenger. So
yes,
it's not a really safe thing to do.
Okay. So the keys are here. Drinking and boating, not a good idea at all. The penalties are the same as if you're driving. So make sure that you have a driver that's in control, responsible, and sober. If you don't have your boater's operation card, you need to get that, because if you're pulled over, there are stiff penalties as well.
Yes.
We sound like a bunch of Debbie Downers, but you know what? I think the message here is have fun, but be responsible.
Yes,
doing so.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, there's lots of fun to be had boating, and it just needs a little bit of pre-planning and no alcohol.
Absolutely. Yeah. All right, Corporal Jody Schelke, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you.
Have a great long weekend.
Thanks, you too.
All right. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Stay with us.